Now, if you search,
utagundua kwamba hiyo wakati ya mavuno ya ngano,
you will find out that during the harvesting of wheat,
walikuwa wanachukua ngano,
they will take the wheat,
na wanachukua hayo mafuta,
and they will take the oil,
na wanavouza,
and as they sell it,
wanapata hiyo sadaka,
they gain the money,
wananunua ngombe,
and they buy cows,
na wananunua vinyo,
and they also buy wine,
na kabla kwanza kusherekea,
and before celebrating,
wanaenda wanatoa sadaka kwa Dagon.
They go and give an offering to their god Dagon. Then they gain more strength.
Nguvu za kishetani za Dagon.
Powers of darkness from Dagon.
Alafu wanasherekea sasa wanakula, wanakunywa, wana mafuta, wana kila kitu. Wanazidi kuwa na nguvu, wanatawala, wanaangamiza Israel.
Then they celebrate it together and they gain more strength. And what do they do next? They go and destroy the Israelites. I told you it was just provoking the Philistines. That's why he went there. Because when he went there, he discovered their character. He knew when they would go and give offering to Dagon. He knew what they did with the wheat and the oil. He went there and discovered. And he knew the season of harvesting. That was the period they gave the sacrifice. He knew that. And that's why he waited. He wanted to go in only during the harvesting period. And that's why he went in. Destroying all the wheat. And all the vineyards of the olive trees. So that they will be broken and their strength will be reduced.
On the other side,
upande mwingine,
ndivyo shetani anakufanyia.
That's how the devil does to you.
Anakunyima neno.
He denies you the word.
Anakufanya usipate upako.
He causes you not to receive anointing.
Ili uzidi kufilisika.
So that you may go down and down.
Anakufanya usimtolee Mungu.
He causes you not to give to God.
Ili Mungu azidi kukubariki.
For God to bless you.
Lakini Wafilistia walijua kumtolea Dagoni.
But the Philistines knew how to give offering to their God.
Lakini wewe haujui kumtolea Mungu
wako. But you don't know how to give to your God.
Alafu hauna nguvu.
And then you are powerless.
Kwa hiyo unazidi kufilisika.
Therefore you run broke.
Na hauzidi kubarikiwa, unazidi kufilisika.
And instead of being blessed, you continue getting broke. And now, if you wanted to give to God, you are not able to do so. We have to have enough wheat.
Lazima tuwe na mafuta ya kutosha.
We have to have enough oil.
Lazima tujue kumfurahisha Mungu wetu.
We have to know how to please our God.
Ili tupate ushindi siku zote.
For us to receive victory always.
Lazima tuwe na ujasiri.
We have to be bold.
Juu ya adui wetu.
Over our enemy. Give praise to the Lord. Now the foxes advanced. And they burned down. And the entire harvest was burned down. And the olive trees were burned down. Therefore, Philistines were gripped with fear. The fear that was among the Israelites was shifted to the Philistines. Do you see that? Fear has to be transferred to the enemy's camp, not your camp. When they were gripped with fear, they said, who has done all this?
Ni Samson ambaye ametuma mbweha kwenye mashamba.
And they said it's Samson who has sent foxes to the vineyards.
Kwa nini?
Why?
Kwa sababu hiyo familia walimtoa mke wake kwa mtu mwingine, Samson akakasirika.
Because that family handed his wife to somebody else and therefore Samson was offended.
Kikawaida,
ordinarily,
wangemwendea Samson.
They would have gone to Samson.
Lakini kwa sababu wanamwogopa Samson.
But because they fear Samson.
Wakaenda hiyo nyumba huko alikooa.
They went to that family where Samson had married from.
Yule baba mkwe na yule mama mkwe.
The father-in-law and the mother-in-law to Samson.
Wakasema, nini mnatuletea shida?
They said, you are bringing trouble to us.
Kwa nini mnamchokoza Samson?
Why do you provoke Samson?
Hamjui huyo ana nguvu za ajabu?
Don't you know that Samson has supernatural power strength? Don't you know that Samson will destroy us?
Sasa mmetuletea shida kubwa namna hii.
You have brought to us great trouble. The Bible says,
wakawaua, wakawachoma.
They burned them, they killed them.
Sasa huone hiyo vita vya kiroho.
Now, aren't you seeing that spiritual battle?
Baada ya kuwaua hao kwa kuwachoma.
After killing them by burning them
maneno
down.
Maneno yaliendelea Wafilistia wote.
Word spread out to the entire Philistine. This is what happened. After they were burned to death, everyone was gripped with fear. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. We Christians today, we ought to be bold.
Lazima tusiongope changamoto yetu.
We ought not to fear our challenges.
Lazima tuwe na mamlaka juu ya shida hiyo inayokuogopesha sana.
We have to have authority over that challenge or
lazima
that predicament.
In charge.
You have to be in charge.
Lazima usiwe peke yako.
Don't stand alone.
Hata kama ni kimwili, hata kiroho.
Whether physically or spiritually.
Lazima usiende kikwako mwenyewe mwenyewe.
Don't walk alone.
Uwe na partner kwenye maisha.
Get a partner in life.
Uwe na partner wa maombi.
Get a partner who prays with you.
Uwe na mtu unaweza kumtrust.
Get somebody that you can trust.
Haumtrust hata mtumishi mchungaji wako.
Don't you trust even your pastor?
Haumtrust hata mume wako.
Don't you even trust your husband?
Haumtrust mke wako.
Don't you even trust your wife?
Partner wako wa maombi.
Your prayer partner.
Ni wewe unamuongelea.
You are the one gossiping about him.
Utashindwa vita.
Then you will surely fail.
Hebu tafakari tena.
Think about again.
Hebu jiulize tena.
Ask yourself again.
Kwa nini nimeachwa peke yangu?
Why have I been left alone?
Kwa nini nimekuwa peke yangu?
Why am I alone?
Jiunganishe tena.
Connect yourself again. Reconnect.
Yes, reconnect again. Na baadaye,
later,
uwe na tabia kuwa na partner wa maombi.
Get a habit of having a partner, a prayer partner.
Na uwe kwenye group ya maombi.
And get into a prayer group.
Biblia inasema wawili au watatu.
Bible says when two or three.
Mwingine anasema mimi nitaomba nyumbani.
And the other one says I'll pray at home.
Lakini unaweza pia ukasinzia.
But you may doze.
Lakini ukiwa kwenye group na wengine.
But if you're in a group with others.
Utapata nguvu.
You will gain strength.
Utatiwa joto.
You will be energized.
Mmoja atapandisha sauti na wewe utapandisha sauti.
One person will raise his voice and you'll also raise yours.
Mafunuo yataanza kushuka.
Revelations will come.
Huyu atapata mafunuo na wewe utapata.
This one will get revelation and the other one will get.
Utafika mbali zaidi.
And you'll go far.
Na baadaye.
Later.
Ujaze roho.
Be filled.
Ujaze roho.
Be filled with the Spirit.
Sio mbweha waliofanya kazi.
It's not the foxes who did it.
Niyo moto.
It is the fire.
Niyo moto.
It is the fire.
Niyo funganishwa nao.
That was tied with them.
Niyo moto.
It is the fire.
Iliyofanya kazi pamoja nao.
That did that thing with them.
Moto haingeenda peke yake.
Fire would not have gone there on its own.
Mbweha hawangeenda peke yao.
And the foxes couldn't do it on their own.
Roho Mtakatifu awe hewani.
The Holy Spirit in the atmosphere.
Roho Mtakatifu awe ndani yako.
This should not be the atmosphere. It should be in the atmosphere. It should be in you.
Roho Mtakatifu anakuhitaji.
The Holy Spirit needs you.
Na wewe unahitaji Roho Mtakatifu.
And you need the Holy Spirit.
Sasa.
Now.
Hauna hata partnership na Roho Mtakatifu.
Look at yourself. You don't have the Holy Spirit as your partner.
Roho anakuambia fanya hivi.
The Spirit tells you do this.
Roho anakuambia fanya hivi.
He tells you to do it. You say, no, it's not possible. No.
Sasa hauna hata partnership na Roho Mtakatifu.
Now, if you are not in partnership with the Holy Spirit.
Anavyokuelekeza unakataa.
When he directs you, guides you, you say no.
Bila moto wa Roho hutaweza.
Without the fire of the Holy Ghost, you cannot do it.
Nakumbuka moto hawezi kufanya bila wewe.
And remember the fire cannot do it without you.
Lakini ukiwa umefungwa na Roho Mtakatifu.
But if you are tied together with the Holy Spirit.
Huwezi kukaa.
You cannot sit.
Kama amekutia moto.
If he has put fire in you.
Moto unawaka.
The fire is burning.
Hiyo mbweha hangeweza kukaa.
The fox could not remain there.
Lazima ataenda mahali.
It has to run.
Kuna majani makavu.
Where the green leaves.
Aingize hiyo mkia huko.
So that it can penetrate its tail there.
Ile moto ihamie kwenye majani.
And the fire will go into the green leaves.
Na yeye apate nafuu.
So that at least it may be a relief to the fox.
Sikiliza.
Listen.
Samson.
Samson.
Aliachilia mbweha.
Release the foxes.
Biblia inasema aliwaachilia kwenye mashamba ya Wafilisti.
The Bible says he released them into the vineyards of the Philistines.
Lakini mbweha wana akili kujua mashamba ya Wafilisti?
But do the foxes really have brains to know that this vineyard belonged to the Philistines?
Hawajui.
No.
Lakini.
But.
Kwa sababu walikuwa wanatafuta relief.
Because they were looking for relief.
Lazima wangeenda mahali ku kuna majani yaliyokauka.
They had to go to where green leaves were.
Majani yaliyokauka.
Green leaves.
Na Samson alijua wamesharundika majani yaliyokauka ambao ni ngano zimetiwa kwenye makundi zimekauka.
And Samson knew these people had already harvested wheat, which was green still. And they had piled them into piles.
Yamekauka.
And they were dry.
Kwa hiyo hao mambweha.
Therefore the foxes.
Walikuwa wanakimbia wanatafuta mahali kuna majani ama mimea iliyokauka ili waingize moto uishie huko wapate relief.
They went to a place where they would find grains or leaves which were dry in order for them to put their tails there and receive some relief.
Kwamba haikuwa kwa kumpenda Samson ilikuwa waweze kutulia waweze kupunguza moto.
The foxes did not do it because they loved Samson, but they did it at least to reduce the pain and to gain relief.
Ulishaona mtu ambaye ana moto wa Roho Mtakatifu?
Have you ever seen somebody full of the fire of the Holy Ghost? He has to release it for him to remain calm. He or she has to pray for somebody. If you have the fire, you can't sit back and relax. You can't. You have to do something. You have to go and do something. You have to burn something. You must connect with something. You must influence something. You must testify. If you see an unbeliever, you'll just go ahead and testify. You have the fire of the kingdom. You will look for somewhere to be influenced. Tell your neighbor, be filled with the Spirit. Be filled with the Spirit. Be filled with the Spirit. And that fire, influence somewhere. Influence. Have you ever seen somebody full of fire? You see him. You see the person. And the wheat, the harvest is ready. You see the harvest. If you say two or three words, he gives his life to Christ immediately. If you bring a prophecy, ready to receive.
Roho ndio atakuelekeza.
The Spirit will guide you.
Mahali pa kwenda.
Where to go.
Roho ndio atakuelekeza.
The Spirit will guide you.
Maneno ya kusema.
The words to say.
Biblia inasema.
The Bible says.
Usijiulize utasema nini.
Don't ask yourself what you'll do.
Utakapofika hapo.
When you get there.
Nitaweka maneno ndani ya kinywa.
I will put words into your mouth.
Na kwa moto wa Roho Mtakatifu.
And by the fire of the Holy Ghost.
Utawasha ndani ya maisha huyo mtu.
You will be able to operate in the world. You will be able to light fire in the life of that person.
Wenye haki wa Mungu.
The righteous of God. They are bold as a lion. They are in charge of everything. They are not timid. They don't fear anyone. They have the fire of God. They burn and destroy.
Hallelujah.
Amen. But the wicked, they flee without being pursued. Give praise to Jesus.
Kama unatafuta kazi.
If you're looking for a job.
Mwangalie yule mtu anaye sign contract yako. Mwangalie kama mavuno yaliyoiva. Majani yamekauka. Ombea nafsi yake. Nenda uongee naye mawili matatu.
Look at the person who is supposed to sign your contract as harvest which is ready. Look at the person as dry grains, dry leaves.
Lakini wewe unaona bosi wako kama adui.
But you look at your boss as an enemy.
Muone kama ngano.
Look at him as wheat.
Ambazo zinatakiwa tukutie mshale hivi.
That is ready to sign.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Umwambie.
Tell him.
Mwambie roho.
Tell the spirit.
Museme kwa jina lake.
Speak.
Huyu bosi wangu fulani.
Mention him by his name.
Ni mavuno yangu.
My boss is my harvest.
Ni mavuno yangu.
So and so.
Is my best.
I am going to light him up with the fire of the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah. Naenda kumwambukiza moto.
I am going to be contagious.
Na kwa hiyo joto atasaini tu.
And because of the heat, he will sign. He will sign.
Atasaini.
He will sign. Wanasifiwe. Praise the Lord.
Bwana Yesu asifiwe.
Praise the Lord.
Bwana Yesu asifiwe.
Praise the Lord.
Tumeitwa kwa watu wenye mguso.
We have been called to be people of impact.
Kwenye unaona shida ujue ni opportunity.
Where you see a problem, that is an opportunity.
Pale unaona shida ni opportunity.
Where you see a problem, it's an opportunity.
Ya kusukuma moto.
Of pushing fire.
Ya kusukuma moto.
Sending fire.
Ya kusukuma moto.
Sending fire.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Nisikilize.
Listen to me.
Nimekumbuka siku moja.
I've remembered one day.
Kwenye Matendo 3.
In Acts 3.
Biblia inasema.
The Bible says.
Petro.
Peter.
Na Yohana.
And John.
Petro.
Peter.
Na Yohana.
And John.
Petro alikuwa mtume mkubwa.
Peter was a great apostle.
Yohana alikuwa mtume mkubwa.
John was a great apostle.
Kwa nini walitembea pamoja?
Why did they walk together?
Lazima wawe wawili.
They had to be two.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Biblia inasema.
The Bible says.
Walikuwa wanaenda kwenye maombi ya saa 9.
They were going for the 3 o'clock prayer.
Walikuwa wanaenda kwenye nyumba ya Mungu.
They were going to the house of God.
Kwenye maombi ya saa 9.
To pray at 3 o'clock.
Walikuwa hawa.
They were two.
Walikuwa wawili.
They were two.
Kama zile mbweha.
Just like the foxes.
Ziliunganishwa kwa pamoja.
Which were tied together.
Wanaongea maneno ya Mungu.
They were discussing words of God.
Wanaongea mafunuo ya Mungu.
Discussing the revelations of God.
Wanaongea kwa lugha kwa pamoja.
Speaking in tongues together.
Wanatembea kwa pamoja.
Walking together.
Biblia inasema.
The Bible says.
Walivyofika.
When they got there.
Kwenye mlango.
At the gate.
Wa hekalu.
Of the temple.
Palikuwa na nani?
Well, who was there?
Kiwete.
There was a lame person.
Palikuwa na kiwete.
There was a lame person.
Tangu kuzaliwa.
From birth. He had been lame.
Na huyo kiwete,
and that lame person
alikuwa naomba watu,
would borrow from people.
Wamlete,
would ask people to bring him.
Wamweke hapo kwenye mlango,
and place him at the gate.
Ili,
so that
kila atakayeingia,
everyone who comes
amrushie rushie tu cents,
will at least give him some few coins.
Alikuwa na nia ambayo sio ya kuokoka.
He had an intention which was not an intention to be saved.
Alikuwa hana nia ya kuingia ndani.
He didn't want to go inside.
Alikuwa karibu.
He was near.
Mbali na mji.
Far from the city.
Karibu na nyumba ya Mungu.
Near the house of God.
Lakini sio ndani ya nyumba ya
Mungu. But not in the house of God.
Maana yeye alijua.
Because he knew.
Faida yake iko nje ya temple.
His profit was only outside the temple.
Ili wamrushie rushie.
People will just give a little.
Rushie.
Little, little.
Lakini hakuwa na nia ya kuingia ndani.
But he didn't have the intention of going inside.
Kwa hiyo huyu.
Therefore this one.
Alikuwa na ulemavu mbili.
He was crippled twice.
Ulemavu wake wa kwanza.
The first lameness. He was lame physically. His legs could not walk. But his second lameness is that he went near something but did not partake of it. You go near something but you can't partake of it. You go near the church but you are not within the church.
You are not in,
you are not in salvation, neither are you in the world. You just go near, but you are not entering,
ili ufalme uingie ndani
mwako, so that the kingdom may penetrate in you.
Hao ni wa Kristo.
These are Christians
wanasogelea wokovu,
who go near salvation.
Wanasogelea kanisa.
They go near the church,
ili waweze kubarikiwa,
so that they may be blessed through salvation.
Lakini,
but
wokovu,
salvation
haukuingia ndani,
does not find its way inside them.
Nani anamuona Yesu?
They see Jesus.
Yesu atambariki. Yesu atamfaidishia biashara yake.
They look at Jesus.
Yesu atampa mke. Yesu atampa hiki. Lakini hajua Yesu ni nani.
They look at Jesus, one who will bring profit to them, make their business grow, give a wife to them, but they don't come to the knowledge of who Christ is.
Ambia mwenzako ingia ndani.
Tell your neighbor, get in.
Ingia ndani.
Get in.
Ingia ndani.
Get in.
Sio ubaki nje.
Don't remain out.
Ingia ndani.
Get in.
Sogelea na uingie.
Go close and enter.
Maana huko ndani.
Because inside.
Una zaidi ya fedha na dhahabu unavyovitafuta.
There is more than money or gold that you're looking for.
Peter na Yohana.
Peter.
Wamefungamana pamoja katika roho.
Walking in one accord in the spirit.
Wanatembea.
Walking together.
Wanaenda kwenye hayo maombi.
They were going for the prayer.
Ndani ya hekalu.
In the temple.
Walivyofika hapo nje.
When they got out there.
Huyo kiwete.
The invalid.
Ni wa tangu zamani.
He had been there for
hata
long.
Hata kipindi cha Yesu.
Even during the time of Jesus.
Alikuwa hapo tu.
He was right there.
Lakini hawa watu.
But these people.
Wamejaa roho.
They were full of the spirit.
Wana moto ndani yao.
They have fire within them.
Akili ingesema.
Now. Ordinarily they would have said.
Akili ingewaambia.
Their brain would have said.
Huyu mbona Yesu hajamponya?
Why didn't Jesus heal this one?
Yeah, mimi
How can I heal him? Their understanding would have said, this is a lame person who has been here for long. It's not possible for him to walk. Even Jesus did not heal him. But they didn't walk by their own understanding. They had fire in them. They had fire in them. There was fire in them. They didn't look at the predicament as a predicament. They looked at it as an opportunity. They looked at it as a harvest. They looked at the lame person as wheat which is dry. If we light fire here, miracles will happen. Miracles will happen. They went close. Every day he was waiting. When he sees somebody coming near, they will have compassion. And they'll give a few coins, silver or gold. But when they came close, the lame man knew they were going to give me money. But Peter said, silver I don't have. Gold we do not have. But whatever I have, I will give to you. And what I have is the name of Jesus. And in the name of Jesus, stand and walk. I don't have silver. I don't have gold. But I have the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, arise and walk in your lameness. They looked at him as dry wheat. Once you put the name of Jesus, immediately a miracle comes to pass. Fire will get lit. A miracle will come to pass. Don't look at a cripple as a cripple, but look at him or her as wheat that is dry, as a harvest, as an opportunity to manifest the power of God. Look at him as dry wheat, whereby the power of God in you, when it is lit, that person will arise and walk. And when they saw that he was fixing his eyes on them, they spoke to him. And not just speaking, but they held him by the hand. They helped him to stand to his feet. They helped his faith. The Bible says, surely he stood. He stood. And when he stood with his two legs, he went in. He went in into the temple. And for the first time, on his two legs, he started glorifying God. He started glorifying God. Now I want to pose this question to you. What kind of lameness do you have? You may have two legs, two eyes, two ears. You have two nostrils. But you have lameness in your soul, which men do not know about. You have two legs, but you're seated. You can't stand. Your salvation is not firm. You're not standing upright. Let me say again. And this is the Spirit speaking to you. You have two legs, but you have a kind of lameness which men do not know about. And that lameness is causing your salvation not to stand firm upright. But once they prayed for him, that lameness disappeared. It is possible it may have been a demon that was oppressing him for long. And when they cast out the demon, he stood. He stood. And he got in and started glorifying the Lord. What is your lameness? Is it the fear?
Ulemavu wako ni nini?
What is your lameness?
Je, ni kutomtii Roho Mtakatifu ndani mwako?
Is it not obeying the Holy Spirit within you?
Ulemavu wako ni nini?
What is your lameness?
Je, ni tabia iliyojificha?
Is it a habit which is hidden?
Ambao watu hawaijui?
That people do not know about?
Lakini Mungu anaijua.
But God knows it.
Ulemavu wako ni nini?
What is your lameness?
Ni kutafuta faida ndani ya wokovu, kutafuta pesa na dhahabu bila kumtafuta Yesu.
Is it looking for material gain, profit of money in salvation and not coming to the full knowledge of Jesus Christ?
Watu waliingia ndani ya kanisa hii.
People entered in that church.
Walijifanya wameokoka.
They behaved as if they are born again.
Na waliomba sana.
And they prayed.
Lakini maombi yao.
But their prayers.
Ilikuwa ya kutafuta pesa.
Were only prayers of looking for money. Silver and gold.
Lakini.
But. Later.
Waliiba watu wa kanisa.
They stole away.
Wakakula hela ya watu.
They stole away money from the people.
Wakaibia watu viwanja, wakafanya vitu vingi.
They swindled money from people, swindled material things from people. They had a lameness.
Ndani ya nafsi zao.
In their souls.
Lakini tukiwaona walikuwa na miguu miwili.
But looking at them physically, they had two legs.
Je, wokovu wako ni wa kukufaidisha?
Is your salvation to bring gain to you?
Au wokovu wako ni wa kumjua Yesu ili ulete na wewe mguso kwa wengine?
Or is your salvation to know Jesus and for you to impact others?
Mwanamke mmoja alisema.
One woman said,
mume wangu ni mzuri sana.
My husband is so good.
Ananipa kila kitu.
He gives me everything.
Ananipenda.
He loves me.
Ananisaidia.
He helps me.
Ananiheshimu.
He honors me.
Lakini ana kilema kimoja.
But he has one lameness.
Ni msherati.
He is a womanizer. He is a fornicator.
Ni mtu mzuri sana.
He's a good man.
Lakini kilema chake.
But his lameness.
Ni katika hiyo hali.
Is in that area.
Lakini ukimuona,
but you look at him.
Ana miguu miwili.
He has two legs.
Lakini huko ndani,
but in his mind.
Ana ulemavu.
He has a lameness.
Mwingine akasema,
one said,
mume wangu ni mzuri sana.
My husband is so good.
Lakini ulemavu wake,
but his lameness.
Ni pombe.
Is alcohol.
Anajificha.
He hides.
Mahali ambapo hamna watu wa wokovu.
Where born again people are not.
Anakunywa pombe.
And he drinks alcohol.
Ulemavu wako ni nini?
What is your lameness?
Udhaifu wako ni upi?
What is your weakness?
Ambao unafanya hausimame.
Which causes you not to stand.
Alivoponya Biblia inasema akasimama, akaingia ndani ya hekalu, akamtukuza Mungu. Ulemavu unaofanya usisimame ndani ya wokovu wako ndio ulemavu ambao unakufanya ukae nje ya ufalme.
The Bible says when he was made whole, he went in and glorified God. It is lameness that causes you not to stand and get in and glorify God.
Ulemavu wako.
Your lameness.
Ni wa tangu zamani.
Has been there for long.
Inawezekana hata ni wa asili.
Possibly it is since you are born.
Angalau hata yule walimjua, lakini ulemavu wako unawezekana haujulikane.
Now better they knew that man, but for you your lameness is not known.
Mwingine ulemavu wake ni ulimi wake.
To others their lameness is their tongue.
Ni mtu mzuri sana.
A good person.
Lakini ulemavu wake
but his lameness is the tongue.
Mwingine ni ulemavu wake ni kukata tamaa.
But to others their lameness is giving up.
Mwingine ni kuogopa shida yake.
Others their lameness is fear of their challenges.
Mungu anamfungulia mlango.
God opens a door.
Lakufu sana.
But he or she fears.
Ulemavu wako ni upi?
What is your lameness?
Ulemavu wako ni upi?
Which is your lameness?
Siku ya leo.
Today.
Mungu anaenda kukuponya.
God is going to heal you.
Na ulemavu huo.
From that lameness.
Siku ya leo.
Today.
Unaenda kusimama.
You are going to stand upright.
Siku ya leo.
Today.
Maisha yako.
Your life.
Yanaenda kumtukuza Mungu.
Will glorify God.
Ile pepo iliyokukalia.
The demon that was oppressing you.
Tunaenda kuichoma siku ya leo.
We are going to cast it out today.
Iyo pepo inaokuzuia.
That demon that limits you.
Tunaenda kuichoma siku ya leo.
We shall burn it today.
Iyo pepo la hofu.
That demon of fear.
Tunaenda kulichoma siku ya leo.
We shall cast it out today.
ili usisimame tena nje,
so that you may not remain outside anymore,
ili usikae tena nje,
so that you may not remain out any longer,
usibebwe siku zote,
you may not be carried every day.
Mchungaji niombe, mchungaji niombe, mchungaji niombe. Usimame siku moja hata na wewe ujue kujiombea.
Pastor, pray for me. Pastor, pray for me. Pastor, carry me. Carry me in prayers. Carry me in prayers. Why won't you one day stand and pray for yourself?
Simaanishi kutafuta kusaidiana na mtu kwenye maombi. Na maanisha una uvivu wa kuomba, unahitaji siku zote watu wakuombee, lakini wewe huombi.
I'm not talking about getting a prayer partner here. You ought to get one. But I'm talking about the laziness or negligence of not praying. You want people to pray for you every day.
Ni ulemavu mkubwa sana.
That is a great lameness.
Biblia inasema ombeni msianguke majaribuni.
Bible says that pray that you may not fall into temptation.
Ulemavu wako,
your lameness,
unaogopa kesho yako.
You fear about your tomorrow.
Huwezi kufanikiwa.
You cannot prosper.
Ukiwaza tu kwamba kesho yangu, oh basi mimi basi.
The moment you think about your tomorrow, you're like, what will happen tomorrow? Woe unto me.
Lazima uone kesho yangu ni bora zaidi ya leo.
You must look at your tomorrow as better, being better than today.
Lakini kama bado unaogopa kesho yako, bado una ulemavu kwenye mawazo yako.
But if you are still fearful about your tomorrow, you are crippled in your mind then.
Ebu kaza macho yako kwa Yesu leo.
Now fix your eyes unto Jesus today.
Na katika jina la Yesu.
And in the name of Jesus.
Ulemavu wako unaweza kaondoka.
Your lameness will go away.
Ukasimama.
And you'll stand.
Wokovu wako ukasimama.
And you're in your salvation you'll be standing.
Na ukaingia ndani.
And you will enter.
Na ukamtukuza Mungu.
And you will glorify God.
Siku ya leo.
Today.
Ni siku ya kukombolewa kwako.
Is a day of your redemption.
Wewe,
you,
unajua,
you know,
mahali pa ulemavu wako.
Where your lameness lies.
Na leo,
and today,
Roho Mtakatifu yuko mahali.
The Holy Ghost is here.
Leo,
today,
na sio kesho,
not tomorrow,
unaenda kufunguliwa.
You're going to be set free.
Na utasimama,
and you will stand,
na utatembea,
and you will walk,
na maisha yako yatakao baki,
and the rest of your life
yatamtukuza Mungu,
will glorify God.
Simama kwa miguu yako.
Stand to your feet.
Leo.
Today.
Leo.
Today,
na sio kesho,
not tomorrow.
Na roho wa Mungu,
if you agree with the Holy Spirit of God,
atakugusa.
He will touch you.
Ulemavu wako,
your lameness,
utaondoka,
will be cast out.
Utasimama kwenye wokovu wako.
You will stand in your salvation.
Mungu atakugusa leo.
God will touch you today.
Na maisha yako yanayobaki,
and the rest of your life,
yatamtukuza Mungu,
will glorify God.
Kwa sababu,
because you cannot glorify God in your lameness. It has been there for so long. I want you to walk forward. The fire of God is here to cast out that demon which brings lameness
tena uje kwa haraka,
and step forward quickly
wakati roho iko hapa kukuhudumia.
As the Holy Spirit is here to minister to you,
usinifuate ofisini,
don't come to the office.
Njoo mahali hapa,
come here
mbele ya kusanyiko,
before the
mbele ya Roho
assembly, before the Holy
moto
Spirit
wa Bwana,
the fire of the Lord
utaichoma hiyo pepo,
will cast out that demon
ambao imekuletea ulemavu,
which has crippled you,
ambao wanadamu hawaujui.
Men do not see the lameness,
lakini Mungu anaujua,
but God knows it.
Na siku ya leo,
and today,
moto wa Mungu uko mahali hapa,
the fire of God is here,
kuchoma,
to burn,
kuteketeza,
to destroy
kile ambacho kinakuzuia,
that which is limiting you,
ndani ya maisha yako,
in your life.
Mungu anahitaji,
God requires,
uwe na miguu miwili,
that you have two legs.
Mungu anahitaji,
God requires,
utembee kwa miguu miwili,
that you walk with two legs.
Mungu anahitaji,
God requires,
uwe na mikono miwili,
that you may have two hands.
Mungu anahitaji,
God requires,
usiwe peke yako,
that you don't stand alone. God requires,
uondoe ulemavu wako,
that He removes,
utaingia ndani,
your lameness, and you will enter.
Utamtukuza Mungu.
You will glorify God.
Mungu
God
anataka
requires to touch you today. You may be asking yourself, it has been many days, it has been a long time, I've been walking with this lameness, but I know it is a secret in my heart. Lord, set me free. God, heal me. God, save me. God, redeem me. God, touch me. In the name of Jesus, that I may be made whole today. I will enter. I will glorify you. I will receive victory over the things that trouble me. That's when I'll gain victory over the thoughts that oppress me. I'll gain power. I'll gain victory over my life. My life will glorify you all the days of my life. Lift up your hands. He said, I don't have silver. I don't have gold. But whatever I have, I give it unto you. And in the name of Jesus, arise. And he stood. He was held by the hand. He was made whole. From the lameness that oppressed him for a long time. Today we shall anoint you with oil. We shall pray for you that you may arise and you may gain victory and you may be in charge, and God will be glorified in your life. You don't have to be troubled. We have Jesus. We have the power of God. We have the Holy Ghost. And the prayer that we shall pray will transform your life in the name of Jesus. I'm going to request the servants of God who are here. They will come and pray with us. We shall anoint you and we shall pray for you, and you will be made whole. You will be healed. You will go in, stand, and be made whole in the name of Jesus. Repenting and asking the Lord to touch you. If there's an area you need repentance, repent. If it is wicked thoughts, repent. Evil habits, repent. Anything hidden, ask the Lord to touch you. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Actually,
katika jina la Yesu. Simama wewe msiku kwa jina la Yesu.
Sima!
moto 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 moto. Thank you.
your feet.
Usichoke.
Don't grow tired.
Usichoke.
Don't grow weary.
Hebu shikamana na mtu mwe wawili wawili.
Hold somebody so that you are two. Two by two.
Wawili ni bora kuliko mmoja.
Two are better than one. Two by two. Not three, not four, but two.
Wawili.
Only two.
Wawili sio watatu, wawili.
Two by two. Two by two.
Wawili.
Two by two.
Wawili kulingana na neno.
According to the word.
Hakikisha umeshikamana na mtu.
Make sure you're holding somebody.
Muombe na ya kuombe.
Pray for the person and let the person pray for you.
Ulemavu wote uliojificha.
Every lameness hidden.
Either kwa roho, kwa nafsi ama kwa mwili.
In the spirit, in the soul or in body.
Muombe awe mzima.
Pray that the person will be whole.
Na uamini kwamba mikono yako ina moto.
And believe that your hands have fire.
Ya kumkomboa.
Of setting the person free.
Ya kumuombea.
Praying for the person.
Ya kumtakasa.
Cleansing the person.
Ya kumubariki.
Blessing the person.
Katika jina la Yesu.
In the name of Jesus. Don't despise the person holding your hand. Pray with power. Pray believing. Pray until you're sure the person is standing.
Ora ba 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 ba